The Skaftá Eldar, Lucky Eruption, a story of fire, poison, and survival. In the summer of 1783, Iceland experienced one of the most catastrophic volcanic eruptions in recorded history. Known locally as Skaftá Eldar, the Skaftá fires, the eruption devastated the island and left scars that persist. Its impacts reached far beyond Iceland's borders, influencing weather patterns, agriculture, and even historical events around the globe. Before delving into the eruption, it was essential to understand Iceland in the 18th century. Iceland was a sparsely populated island with around 50,000 inhabitants at the time. The people lived mainly as farmers and fishermen, relying heavily on their environment for survival. Agriculture was central to their way of life. They cultivated barley and hay and raised livestock like sheep, cows, and horses. The island's economy was fragile, vulnerable to harsh winters, volcanic eruptions, and other natural calamities. Volcanic activity was no stranger to Iceland. The island sits atop the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, a geological hotspot where tectonic plates pull apart, allowing magma to rise and create volcanic systems. While eruptions were relatively common, few had the scale and consequences of the Skaftá Eldar eruption. It began like many Icelandic eruptions, with a series of earthquakes. For days, tremors shook the ground in southern Iceland, particularly near a volcanic fissure known as Laki, part of the Grímsvötn volcanic system. Then, on June 8, 1783, the earth cracked open and lava began to pour out of the fissure. The fissure was enormous, stretching approximately 27 kilometers, 17 miles. Over the next 8 months, it released 14 cubic kilometers, 3.4 cubic miles of lava, enough to cover a city the size of Los Angeles in molten rock. This lava flowed across the landscape, destroying everything in its path. Fields, farms, rivers, and villages were consumed. In addition to the lava, the eruption released a vast cloud of poisonous gases, including sulfur dioxide, hydrogen fluoride, and carbon dioxide. These gases caused immediate health problems for people and animals, and they would go on to have devastating long-term effects. The eruption unfolded in stages. Lava fountains shot hundreds of meters into the air, creating fiery columns visible for miles. The lava flowed in two main directions, following the Skaftá and Vefnisfjörður rivers. While the lava itself caused widespread destruction, the toxic gases were even deadlier. Sulfur dioxide mixed with moisture in the atmosphere to create acid rain, which poisoned the soil and water. Hydrogen fluoride settled on vegetation, contaminating the grass that livestock depended on for food. Animals that ate this grass suffered severe internal injuries, and many died within days. The air became so thick with ash and smoke that people could barely breathe. Eyewitnesses described the sky as dark and ominous, with the sun appearing as a dim red orb. Day and night blurred as the haze engulfed the land. The eruption had a catastrophic impact on Iceland's population. It's estimated that 20% of the island's people, around 10,000 individuals, died as a result of the disaster. However, it wasn't the eruption itself that caused most of these deaths. It was the famine and disease that followed. Over 50% of Iceland's livestock, sheep, cattle, and horses, died from eating poisoned grass or drinking contaminated water. This loss was devastating for farmers, as their animals were not just sources of food, but also essential for transportation and farming. The ash and acid rain ruined the soil, making it impossible to grow crops. Hay production, crucial for feeding animals during Iceland's long winters, collapsed. With no livestock and no crops, people had nothing to eat. They resorted to desperate measures, eating whatever they could find, including seaweed, birds, and even the leather from their shoes. Malnutrition weakens people's immune systems, making them more vulnerable to diseases like dysentery and scurvy. The harsh living conditions only made matters worse. This period of suffering became known as Moduharðindin, or the missed hardships. It was one of the darkest times in Iceland's history. What made the Skaftá Eldar eruption unique was its global impact. The gases released into the atmosphere spread far beyond Iceland, creating a volcanic haze that circled the northern hemisphere. This haze disrupted weather patterns, caused crop failures, and led to widespread suffering. In Europe, the summer of 1783 was unusually hot, with reports of stifling heat and a persistent haze that blocked out the sun. People described the air as suffocating, with a foul smell that caused respiratory problems. Crops failed in many regions due to the strange weather, leading to food shortages. Rivers dried up in some areas, while others experienced severe storms and flooding. The winter of 1783-84 was one of the coldest on record, with heavy snow and ice causing further hardships. In France, the Seine River froze solid, and famine became widespread. Some historians argue that these hardships contributed to the unrest that led to the French Revolution in 1789. In North America, the winter of 1784 was exceptionally harsh. The Mississippi River reportedly froze near New Orleans, an event so rare it was almost unheard of. The extreme cold damaged crops and disrupted livelihoods. The eruption also affected the monsoon systems in Asia and Africa. In India, disrupted rainfall patterns led to drought and famine. In Egypt, the Nile River's flood levels dropped significantly, causing agricultural failures and starvation. The Skaftá eruption released an estimated 120 million tons of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere, significantly affecting the Earth's climate. The volcanic gases created a phenomenon known as a volcanic winter, where the particles in the atmosphere reflect sunlight, cooling the planet. This cooling effect, combined with other factors, contributed to the late 18th century being one of the coldest periods of the Little Ice Age. Amid the devastation, stories from survivors paint a vivid picture of life during the eruption. Farmers watched helplessly as their animals died and their fields turned to ash. Communities banded together to share resources, but even that was often not enough. One famous account comes from Thorvaldur Thorvaldsen, a priest who chronicled the eruption in his diary. He described the horrors of the event, from the lava flows to the suffocating haze. His writings remain an essential historical record of the eruption. Despite the suffering, the Icelandic people showed remarkable resilience. After the eruption ended in February 1784, survivors began the long process of rebuilding their lives. They reclaimed the land where possible and adapted to the new, harsher environment. Modern scientists have studied the Skaftá eruption extensively to understand its causes and effects. Here are some key findings. The eruption was unique because it occurred along a fissure rather than a single volcanic cone. This allowed lava to flow across a vast area, causing widespread destruction. The amount of sulfur dioxide released was unprecedented, making Skaftá one of the largest gas-emitting eruptions in history. By studying ice cores and tree rings, scientists have confirmed that the eruption caused significant climate disruptions. These studies help us understand how future eruptions might affect the planet. The lava flows from the Laki fissure reshaped southern Iceland's landscape. Today, visitors to Vatnajökull National Park can see the craters and lava fields left behind, a stark reminder of the eruption's power. The Skaftá eruption remains a defining moment in Icelandic history. It showed the world the incredible power of volcanic activity and its ability to influence global systems. For Iceland, it was a period of immense suffering, but also resilience and recovery. Today, the Laki fissure is a popular destination for tourists and scientists alike. It serves as both a natural wonder and a historical site, preserving the memory of the disaster. The Skaftá eruption is a powerful reminder of humanity's vulnerability to natural disasters. It highlights the interconnectedness of life on Earth, how an event in a small island nation can ripple across the globe, affecting climate and leading to famine and suffering. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you taking the time to explore this story with me. If you found this video interesting or thought-provoking, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share it with others who might enjoy it too. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you won't miss out on any future videos where we dive into intriguing mysteries, untold histories, and the wonders of the unknown.